everyone, this is Tori from Totally Cool Totally Art, and everybody at TCTA is social distancing and just doing our part. However, we still want to encourage creativity and making, so for this video, I'm going to show you all how I do my own paintings. My process, my start to finish, and what I'll be doing in quarantine. And I really hope you enjoy. Okay, so I will be using a variety of my paintbrushes, and I also have a different variety of acrylic paints, all from different brands. It doesn't really matter as long as they're all like water-based paints. I also have some paper plates that I will be using as a palette, and I will have water. I will be using a canvas panel for this painting. I need to save the plastic, however, because that will be used later on in the video to make the painting. And most importantly, I have a cup of coffee. I try my hardest to keep these as separate as possible because I have made that mistake many a time. So next, this process was actually brought to me by Ian McDonald. It's called Decalcomania, and it's super fun and I love it. So you get like a base color, preferably a dark color, and you just mix it with as much water as you can till it's like this consistency, and you cover the whole entire painting in this. Once you've completed that, you get some plastic and you just press onto the piece. And as you do this, all these like interesting, crazy textures start to develop, and these textures are the basis for what I'm creating. They are the starting point, and it's just so interesting and I love doing this. And then I just have fun with it for a while. I just throw on paint, take it off, add plastic, add water, and I just keep doing this and just having fun exploring. There's not a lot of thinking, just a lot of doing, and it's very cathartic. And this is just one of the like fun, easy, just going with the flow portions of me making a painting. And then I start to develop it a little bit more. So I get some dark paint and I start, you know, like outlining, blocking out, making a composition of what I want within all the textures and all the like mess of paint. Then I create a lighter color to just like give it some contrast, add some volume, and just to see what I'm doing a bit more. And then once it's dry, I start glazing, where I get water and the paint really thin, and I just start like covering pieces, but not like thick enough of paint that I lose the texture behind it. And that's how I do a lot of the process of coloring for it. And this is where the piece starts coming alive, and I get really excited about that, and it's really fun. And I get a little messy, and that doesn't matter in these beginning stages. And then I also like to take some puppy pet breaks, because how can you not? I mean, look at that face. So for the next few days, I actually start building up detail, adding color, using paint markers, even adding gouache as like a detail layer on top. And I just really delve into it. This is more of the like intentional phase of the painting. It's still very fun and I'm still exploring, but it's a lot more direct and a lot more about the final product. And I just keep messing around and playing and just not stopping until I come up with something that I really like. And yeah, so this is how I personally paint, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks.